kuna amani huru.
Maadhimisho ya siku ya kampeni dhidi ya ufisadi barani Afrika yanafanyika hapa mjini Nairobi. Kauli mbiu ni ikiwa ni kuimarisha ulinzi kwa wanaofichua ufisadi. Mwenyekiti wa tume ya kupambana na ufisadi nchini EACC, Dr. David Oginde, na afisa mkuu wa tume hiyo Twalib Mbarak wanaongoza maadhimisho hayo.
This is why, you know, protecting whistleblowers, really establishing a system for them to report safely and be protected against retaliations of all sorts is really fundamental. Now, we have the United Nations Convention Against Corruption. The convention is really very specific on this point. Of course, also the African Union Convention Against Corruption is specific on the fact that state parties should establish measures to protect whistleblowers.
In Kenya, and I'm glad that the EACC undertook this survey under the National Ethics and Corruption Survey of 2023, we reported just views from the citizen that corruption ranked as the fourth most pressing challenge facing the country after high cost of living, unemployment, and poverty. According to the report, 60% of the respondents were dissatisfied with integrity, transparency, and accountability in public service delivery.
We have quite a number of people, and this is an experience in EACC. People are reporting an incident, not because they wanted to investigate, it's because they want to fix somebody. Quite common when there's an appointment of a CEO in that company. People take ethnic lines. People say, now let us use EACC as a springboard to finish this person. So even the recipient of a whistleblower report, you must be very careful how you are handling it, because sometimes it is blended with vendetta and personal interest.
Effective implementation and enforcement are critical for the success of these laws in protecting people who come out to point out what may be going on in the space where they find themselves.
Wanafunzi wa chuo cha kiufundi cha Borabu huko Nyamira waliandamana kulalamikia utovu